Hallelujah. Greetings to you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It's again a great joy even to meet you through this short time of meditation. Welcome to the place where you learn the Bible. I couldn't upload the regular devotion, regular message that I usually upload on Sundays. It's usually a very long Bible study, mostly on a character. Mostly it's a character study, but because of some issues, today I couldn't record it and upload it. But then so I'm just going to talk to you from my daily meditation, something what God impressed in my heart, and I'm sure even this will be a blessing to you all. And I hope to be on track from next Sunday so that I can start uploading on character studies, a lengthy sermon basically. Yeah, so now let's get into the subject. So we know the New Testament has four Gospels, and those four Gospels portray the four dimensional picture of our Lord Jesus Christ. So out of these four Gospels, there are many things mentioned in these four Gospels. We have the parables, we have miracles, we have teachings, and when you look at the Gospel of John, even there is some kind of doctrinal content, right? But the thing that I want to talk to you about are those parables. Now, Luke has 28 parables. So basically, I'm just trying to give you a fact of the Bible. So Luke has, the Gospel of Luke has 28 parables. The Gospel of Matthew has 23 parables. Mark has 9 parables, and John has 0. John has no parable at all. It's highly a doctrinal book. Now, so among the stories of what Jesus said, the most is in the Gospel of Luke 28. Now, from that gospel, we are going to look at one familiar story, and I would say for many this is one of their most well-known story or a parable that almost from kindergarten children are taught. In Luke chapter 15, talks of three parables. One they call it as the lost sheep, another they call it as the lost coin, and another one they call it as the lost son. Though the third parable, I always personally like to call it as the younger son more than the lost son. Yes, he was lost, but then he came back. I would like to call it either as the I would like to call that parable basically as a loving father more than the younger son. I would like to call the parable as the loving father. Okay, but today I'm going to talk about the parable of the lost sheep. Luke chapter 15 from verse 3. Luke 15 and verse 3. Then Jesus told them this parable. I'm reading it from the NIV. Then Jesus told them this parable. Suppose one of you has 100 sheep and loses one of them. Doesn't he leave the 99 in the open country and go after the lost sheep until he finds it? And when he finds it, he joyfully puts it on his shoulders and goes home. Today I want to talk to you about the parable of the lost sheep. So we know this parable very well, so I'm not going to again explain this parable. But in this short time, I just want to talk about two lessons that I personally learned, even as I was reading these couple of verses. Two lessons. Number one, both these lessons are from the angle of the shepherd. And both these lessons are for our life application. Number one, never give up. See, think of this shepherd. This shepherd, he had 100 sheep. He lost one. You know, it's like my dad bought me 10 pencils. I took all the 10 pencils to school, which no parent would allow. But let's take it that I took all the 10 pencils to school out of my own excitement, and I lost one pencil. What do you think I will do? I will at least try to save my other 9 pencils and come back home safe so that my father will be happy. Okay, at least there is the remaining 9 is there. So this guy, he had 100 sheep and he lost one. If you and I were in our capacity, we would think, okay, at least save this 99. But this guy, he doesn't do it. He leaves the 99 and he goes after the one. You know, unless and until we realize that we are that one lost sheep and the shepherd is after us, we will not know the value, the importance of it. The first lesson from this parable is this: the shepherd, he never gave up. I do not know how many mountains he had to cross, how many kilometers he had to walk just to go, and how many thorns he had to walk through, how many bushes he had to search. But this shepherd, he never gave up in trying to find that one lost sheep. Today I want to tell you, never give up in your pursuit. Never give up in your pursuit. Are you praying for the salvation of somebody in your family? Never give up. Are you praying for a blessing? Never give up. Are you trying to get a good job? Never give up. Never ever give up. Today, one of the main reasons why there are so many suicides in this world is because people are giving up. People are giving up. Death rate is increasing because people are giving up. Today, I want to encourage you by this. The shepherd, he never gave up. You know, this is the character of shepherd. When you read 1 Samuel chapter 17, David was a shepherd. Though David was a small boy, yet he was a shepherd. And before going and facing Goliath, he had to meet Saul to get the king's permission to go and face the enemy. So when he went to meet Saul, he was talking about all the exploits that he did as a shepherd. And 1 Samuel chapter 17 and verse 34, he talks about saying, "Your servant has been keeping his father's sheep. When a lion or a bear came and carried off the sheep or a flock," verse 35, David says, "I went after it, a lion or a bear. I went after the lion and the bear, struck it and rescued the sheep from its mouth." You know, the sheep was in the mouth of the lion and the bear. I went after it and I never gave up. I didn't think, okay, let me save the other 99 sheep. You know, I do not want the other 99 to be killed by that same lion. I didn't think like that, but I went after it and I rescued the sheep from its mouth. Yes, the sheep was already in the mouth of the lion. Yes, the sheep was already in the mouth of the bear, but I went after it and I made sure that even that sheep is safe. Today, I want to tell you, you might be a father, you might be a husband, you might be an employer, you might be a pastor, you might be a leader, whoever you are. Number one, never ever give up. What does this parable teaches us? From the lost sheep, it's not just about salvation, it is not just about the rejoicing in heaven. The first lesson is never give up, never give up. Secondly, the second lesson is this: never despise the minority. Never despise the minority, because God's evaluation is completely different from the world's. God's way of evaluating things, God's valuation is completely different from the world's, from the way the man values some things. Never despise the minority. Never despise the day of beginning. Never despise the little things in your life. You know, we say, you know, this is little, never we can despise it. You know, this shepherd didn't despise that one number. You know, we think usually, okay, a man with a rich purse, a man with a lot of wealth, a man with a big job, we value them. But here, this shepherd, he never despised, though that lost sheep was just one in number. He went after it. He went after it. Never despise the minor things in your life. In fact, it is these little things in your life that adds more value to your life. Let me repeat it. It is the little things in your life that adds more value to your life. More value to your life. You know, you might be a person in a very big job. You might be earning a lot. And you will have two little children at home. You know, the most valuable thing is not your job. It is those two little children. You know, you might have a big car. You might have a big house. You might be a big shot. But those doesn't matter. What you think is the least. You know, think of Naaman's life. If that servant girl hadn't said about Elisha, that servant girl's little words changed him from a leper to another, to skin. The Bible says his skin became a skin like that of a child's. You know, don't despise the minor things in your life. Never despise it. Never despise it. The shepherd didn't despise that one, but he went after it. I would say like this, like how David, he went after it. Though it was in the mouth of the lion, he went and rescued it. He went and rescued it from the mouth of the lion and the bear. Today I want to tell you, you would have read this parable again and again in your life. Luke chapter 15, the parable of the lost sheep. But even after reading it, if you do not understand these two lessons, I think it's time to ask God to give us the strength never to give up, and the grace and the wisdom never to despise the little things in your life. never to despise the little things in your life. May God be with you, and let these two lessons, let them be applied in our lives. You know, I'm including even me. Let us apply these two principles in our life so that we will be a blessing, and we will also be blessed. May God be with us, and may God guide us. Stay safe. And also, whenever you remember us, please do pray for us. Thank you. God bless you. Amen. Amen.